वेलकम व्यूअर्स, सो आई विल गिविंग यू सम आइडिया अबाउट सेट्स चैप्टर, ओके, फ्रॉम जेईई मेन डॉक्टर खट्टर बुक. नाउ इन माय प्रीवियस क्लास आई हैव डन व्हाट इज यूनिवर्सल सेट, व्हाट इज कॉम्प्लीमेंट, what is symmetric difference, disjoint set, okay, operation on set. Now today I will start algebra of set, algebra algebra of set. Now for knowing the algebra, we have to know about some law. That is, first law is idempotent law. Okay, what is idempotent law? For any set A, we have A, for any set A, we have A union A is equal to A. For any set A, we have A union A is equal to A, and A intersection A is equal to A. This is the first idempotent law, and this is the second one. Idempotent law. Understand? Next, identity law. Identity law. What is the identity law? For any set A, we have A union phi is equal to A. A intersection phi is equal to phi. A union the universal set U, capital U, is equal to U, and D is A intersection the universal set is equal to A. Next, commutative law. Commutative law. For any two set A and B, we have A union B is equal to B union A, and A intersection B is equal to B intersection A. So this is my commutative law. Next, associative. Student, this is very important lecture that I have given to you, and from a very important book. Okay, so you just go through and listen all the terms, go through my lecture carefully. Okay, you should be benefited, definitely. And next, associative law. For any three set ABC. Any three set ABC, we have A union B intersection C is equal to A union B intersection. No, sorry. This is distributive law. I am telling you. What is associative law? For any three set ABC, A union B intersection C is equal to A union B intersection C. This is associative law. Okay, next, B. A intersection B union C is equal to A intersection B union C. So these are the associative law. Next, distributive distributive law. What is distributive law? For any three set ABC, what is distributive law? A union B intersection C is equal to A union B intersection A union C. And second is A intersection B union C is equal to A intersection B union A intersection C. So this is my distributive law. Now we have known already the power set, the sixth algebra or property. For any two set A and B, P of A intersection P of B is equal to P of A intersection B. This is the first, and the next is P of A union P of B is equal to P of A union B. Okay. No, union is not equal to P of A union P of B is a subset of P of A union B. Okay, where PA is the power set. PA is power set of A. Okay. You can verify it by taking examples. I am not showing it by example, but you can definitely verify it from example. You can take yourself example and try to show it. You will be get it. Okay, definitely. Now, 7. If A is a set, then A complement equal to A. Okay, A complement is equal to A. Next, come to De Morgan's law. De Morgan, a mathematician, given some law regarding the set. Okay, so we have to show that De Morgan's law. De Morgan's law. What is De Morgan's law? The first De Morgan's law is A union B complement is equal to A complement intersection B complement. This is the first. Okay. A union B complement is equal to A complement intersection B complement. Next, second, A intersection B complement is equal to A complement union B complement. Third, A minus B union C is equal to A minus B union A minus C. And the fourth, A minus B intersection C is equal to A minus B union A minus C. Sorry guys, B union C is equal to A minus B intersection A minus C. This is intersection A minus C. Okay, means if we subtract from A set the union of B union C, then we get A minus B intersection A minus C. So these are some algebra of set. Next, come to some key result regarding the set. Okay, various types of key result they are most probably. First is A is a subset of A is a subset of A union B, and B is a subset of A union B. Okay, and A intersection B is a subset of A, and A intersection B is also a subset of B. Okay, next come to 2. A minus B is equal to A intersection B complement. 3. A minus B union of B is equal to A union B. Next, 4. A minus B intersection B is equal to 5. You can verify this key result, okay, and the algebra which I have already given to you. You can verify it easily by taking some examples. You should try it in yourself, okay. Next, question number 4. So, question number 4 is done. Next, 5. A is a subset of B. That's implying A is a subset of B. That's implying B complement is a subset of A complement, and vice versa. Means, if A is a subset of B, then B complement is a subset of A complement. And if B complement is subset of A complement, then we can say that A is a subset of B. Okay. Next, 6. A minus B is equal to B complement minus A complement. Next, 7. A union B intersection A union B complement is equal to A. Next, 8. A union B is equal to A minus B union B minus A union A intersection B. This is my A union B. Next, A minus B is equal to A intersection B. Next, 10. What is my 10? That A minus B is equal to B minus A. That imply and implied by A equal to B. If this happen, then A equal to B will be happen, and if A equal to B, then this will be happen. Okay. Next, from 11. A union B is equal to A intersection B. That's also imply and implied by A is equal to B. Next, 12. A intersection B symmetric difference of C is equal to A intersection B symmetric difference A intersection C. So these are the key results. This is the symmetric difference. You know what is symmetric difference. Now, some result from the cardinal number, related to cardinal number. cardinal number. You know what is cardinal number opposite. Now first is, if A, B, C are finite set, A, B, C are the finite set and U B universal set, then the first is n of A complement is equal to n of U minus n of A. Second, n of A union B is equal to n of A